Heather here with Heather Oliver Fitness. How are you doing today? Let's talk about motivation. What do? It's just so hard, right? You want to work out, you have everything you need, but you just can't seem to actually create a habit, create a routine. How can you get motivated? I have 5 tips that I'm hoping can help you to get motivated so that you can create a workout habit that you can stick to. I would say this though, always have grace with yourself when there is something new that you are trying to implement and you're trying to push yourself outside of the box. You have to have grace with yourself. Okay, let's get to it. So, number one, reward yourself after your workout. And I don't necessarily mean with food. I mean, I never work out, right? So today, after my workout, I'm gonna earn my favorite TV show tonight, or I'm gonna be able to take a hot bath. You know, just dangle some sort of carrot in front of your face that you cannot have until after you get your workout done. Okay? So reward yourself. Find some way, some carrot that you can dangle in front of your face that you can work out for. That's not necessarily food. Tip number 2, wear a cute workout outfit. Have some cute workout clothes that you actually want to wear. Put them on. You don't want to waste them. They're meant to be like sweating. So once you have them on, you're going to have to commit to your workout. Cute workout clothes definitely make you want to work out. Maybe even want to make you take a post-workout selfie, which leads me to tip number 3. Find yourself an accountability partner. Tell somebody before you're going to work out, hey, I'm about to work out. I'm going to tell you when I'm done. And then that way you already know somebody's expecting you to tell them, I finished working out. So now you are committed because you have to tell this person you did what you said you were going to do. You want to be someone who keeps the promises they make to themselves, right? So you tell somebody you're going to work out and now you are committed to going to get your workout done. Tip number 4, set a goal you can reach. If you do not ever work out at all, and the idea of working out for an hour is too much for you, do not set the goal to work out for an hour. Set the goal that you can reach. You are starting out. This is the beginning. It doesn't matter if it's the shortest workout ever if you worked out. So if all you can do is 10 minutes, be proud of that and know that that's a starting point. Okay, so set a goal you know you can achieve. That way, once you achieve it, you're gonna feel so good and you're gonna wanna do it again and again and again. And the goal can get greater the longer you work out. And tip number 5, create a workout routine. This is how you're gonna actually create a habit. You create a routine around your working out. Okay, so for me, I eat a pre-workout meal. Usually it's a rice cake. Usually it's like a rice cake with some honey on it or something like that. Maybe a protein shake before, but usually that's after. So I create a routine by 1, I eat my pre-workout meal, whatever that is for you. Okay, I eat my meal. Then I start going and getting mentally ready. I look at my workout notebook. I look at what my workout is going to be for the day. I decide for me if I'm going to work out inside or outside. If I'm going to work out outside, what equipment do I need to take with me? And I start getting ready. Okay, some other things you can do. Put on your favorite song that pumps you up. Eat your pre-workout meal, put on your jam and jump around and get excited, get motivated. Okay, this is how, these are the kinds of things I do. You have to kind of just get yourself in the mood, okay? You get your pre-workout meal, you listen to some jams, maybe you go ahead and you read some inspirational quotes or watch a workout video even, watch somebody else work out. I love watching other people work out. Like, that totally motivates me, you know? So you wait your 20, 30 minutes and then you go ahead. You're ready now. You've had your pre-workout meal. You've mentally prepared. You've looked at your workout. You know what you're going to do, right? And now you can go ahead and go get your workout done, okay? And then I would say the routine continues. Now you're done with your workout. Take a post-workout selfie. Even if you don't share it with anybody, it's good for you. You did it. Be excited. Yeah. Workout done. Check mark. And if you want to share it, do, because again, it encourages people. I love seeing people work out. I love it. Okay. And then after that, and maybe even before your post-workout selfie, you should have your post-workout protein Okay, but after you're done with your workout, you go ahead and you get your protein and you take your post-workout selfie. And now you've got a whole routine. And now you know what to expect. And now it's not so overwhelming every time, right? Because you're mentally prepared and you're not just throwing yourself into it. So I really hope that these tips are helpful. These are things that I do to motivate myself, to help myself stick to my habit. Here's the real bottom line, though. True motivation really is self-discipline. At the end of the day, you just have to decide, am I going to do this or not? Nobody can make you. I can give you all the tips in the world, but you are the one who has to implement them and put them into action. Let me know if these work for you, and if you need any other help, please reach out. And if you need an accountability partner, let me know. I'd love to see your pre-workout selfies, your post-workout selfies. Like I said, I love seeing people work out. Share that with me. I hope you have a great day.